Homicide has struck the Chicago Police Department for the fourth time this year. This time it was a 40-year-old officer who worked in the Rogers Park neighborhood on the city's north side. Police say the 17-year veteran was well-liked and a friend to many in the department. He is survived by his wife and three young children. Superintendent Eddie Johnson and grief counselors are meeting with workers in the 24th Police District today. And suicide among Chicago police officers is more than double the national average. It's actually led the department to talk more openly about the challenges cops face and the help that's available. As part of that effort, in April, I spoke with department leaders about their own struggles with depression.
I reached out for help. Other people can too.
Four current and former Chicago cops sharing piercingly personal stories.
I didn't actually want to take my own life, but I did not want to live.
To take a bottle of pills. I do remember being taken to the hospital.
I sat in my car to the following day, 0500, which is 5 a.m. in the morning, contemplating, how can I get rid of this pain?
Officer Corey Chapton remembers sitting in his car all night outside the 11th District on the west side, thinking of ending his life.
I'm done, tired, don't want to deal with this no more. You get to that point that this ended all. Forget it.
The reasons are all different. The stress of being a cop, the constant barrage of suffering they see on the streets, postpartum depression, or maybe a messy divorce. The reasons may matter less than the pain and isolation.
Getting up every day became a struggle. I dreaded getting up. I dreaded when the alarm went off because I would have to face reality.
Even Chicago's top cop says he became overwhelmed years ago and needed help.
I still remember that night. I pulled over on the side of the street and I said, I have to talk to somebody. It was about 2 o'clock in the morning. Picked up the phone and called DAP. And they talked to me for the 2 hours that I needed to unpack it. And once I unpacked it, I left it right there.
What do all these people have in common? They sought help, and their careers did not suffer.
It didn't prevent me from being a sergeant, a lieutenant, a commander, a deputy chief, a chief in various functions, and then being asked to come back as a civilian.
I guarantee nobody knew that I ever went to get myself help. I know it remained confidential.
Over on Milwaukee, what is that, 16?
Yep, way up north.
In October, we showed you how the police department was deploying six chaplains to counsel cops on the beat.
And please remember that you're not doing it alone. You got a great support system here in the police department.
The department, though, has struggled to hire enough counselors, so now it's advertising internal and external resources for help. For Officer Corey Chapton, knowing a friendly boss had just come on shift brought him out of his car and out of the darkness.
And I don't know what it was that day, but I felt comfortable with this supervisor. I went and talked to him, he closed the door. We had the heart of heart. It changed from there.
Important perspectives from a piece we first reported in April. If you are struggling and need someone to talk to, the National Suicide Prevention Lifeline has round-the-clock help. That number, 800-273-8255. Website is suicidepreventionlifeline.com.